this question asks us, what is the initial quality of steam within this box? It's a rigid box and contains water, and it contains water vapor, and the two are in equilibrium. And it tells you that the volume of the box is 1.5 cubic meters. The total mass within the box, the mass of the liquid water plus the mass of the water vapor, is equal to 15 kilograms. And it tells you that the temperature of the two in equilibrium is 100 degrees C. So what is the initial quality of steam in the box? And to answer this, you first need to understand what quality means. And it simply means what fraction of the mass within this box consists of vapor. So a quality of 100% would mean that the box was entirely comprised of what we call steam or water vapor. If the quality was zero, it would mean that the box is completely filled with liquid water. And if the quality was 50%, it means that half of the mass would be comprised of vapor, and half of the mass, 50% of the mass, would be comprised of water. So that does not mean that the box would be half full of water and half full of vapor. It would mean that half of the mass is comprised of water. And because water is so much more dense than the vapor, you might only see just a small puddle of water on the bottom, and that's still a quality of 50%. So to solve this problem, I try to figure out intensive variables that I can use to relate this to the steam table. And one thing I really like to do is to draw a couple of columns denoting what I know about the problem. And in state one, I know I've got a specific volume of 1.5 cubic meters divided by 15 kilograms. So a specific volume of 0.1 cubic meters per kilogram. I know I've got two intensive variables, temperature and specific volume, and then I've got water and water vapor in equilibrium. I can consult the saturated water temperature table. This temperature table is organized so that I can look up temperatures real quickly. So the first column, temperature, and I see the temperature that I'm interested in at 100 degrees C, and I look up the saturated pressure of that. And this is right around 1 atmosphere of pressure. And it gives you some more information, like the specific volume gives you the internal energy, the enthalpy, the entropy of the system. But for right now, what we're interested in is the specific volume of this system. It gives you two columns, and the first column is the specific volume of the saturated liquid, and the second column is the specific volume of saturated vapor. So it's important to notice that the specific volume of vapors are always greater than the specific volumes of liquid. So if we look at 100 degrees C, the specific volume for the liquid is 0.001 cubic meters per kilogram. That's the inverse of the density. Conversely, we look at the specific volume of the saturated vapor, and we're looking at something about 3 orders of magnitude greater in volume. So what this is saying is that if I took 1 kilogram of water, it would have a volume of 0.001 cubic meters, or a volume of 1 liter. And I boiled all that water, and I captured all that steam in a big bubble. That would mean that the volume would grow from 0.001 to about 1.7 cubic meters. I can use that information now to solve my problem. And the easiest way to do it is to use this ratio, and it's a ratio of the difference in specific volumes. So this is the specific volume of the system, and it's the difference between this and the specific volume of the liquid, and it's divided by the specific volume of pure vapor and the difference between that and the specific volume of the liquid. One thing to note is that if I had a condition in which my specific volume was equal to that of the vapor, then the numerator and the denominator would be equal, and the quality then would be equal to 1. And if I had a specific volume that was equal to the specific volume of the liquid, I would have a quality of 0. So in this case, I run the calculations, and I've got a quality of about 0.059, or about 6%. So 6% of the mass within this box is comprised of vapor. So I can also do this calculation using ease, and it's just one line of code here. Let's define a variable x1 and use the quality function. And it'll work with water. Type it out. Remember, don't use H2O because it'll treat it like an ideal gas. And this is a two-phase equilibrium mixture, and the ideal gas law does not apply in this case. Let's type out water. You can also type out steam, but I'll type out water. And we've got a temperature equal to 100 degrees C. I always use units just to make sure I'm doing things correctly. And I've got a specific volume V, which is equal to 1.5 cubic meters divided by 15 kilograms. So push the calculator button, and indeed I get a quality of 0.05916, which jives with our hand calculations from that table. So the second problem is asking, what is the temperature if we add heat to this system? What is the temperature when all of the water boils off? The first thing I do is draw a PV diagram. So I've got pressure on the y-axis, I've got specific volume on the x-axis, and then I draw this two-phase envelope. So what you know now is that you've got subcooled liquid here, we've got a two-phase region up here, and superheated vapor. And you know the specific volume is about 0.1 cubic meters per kilogram. So somewhere on here, we're located on some vertical line, and I'll call this 0.1 cubic meters per kilogram. And it's also telling me that I've got a temperature of 100 degrees C. So on these diagrams, remember, there's isotherms that come down, they come horizontally across in the two-phase region, and then they continue down off to the right. So this is the isotherm of 100 degrees C. I've now located this thermodynamic state of the system on this PV diagram. And that initial state is right at the intersection of a specific volume of 0.1 in a temperature of 100 degrees C. It says state 2 occurs when the last droplet of water vaporizes. So I've got one column of information. Let me draw another column, state 2. The specific volume of state 2 has to be the same as the specific volume of state 1. And that's because no mass has left the system, the volume hasn't changed. I want to figure out where state 2 is located. So I know it still has to be somewhere on this vertical blue line, but I don't know where just yet. And I have to think about the problem for a second. And the key word here is when all the water boils off. So in other words, when we're just at the water vapor equilibrium line, so this black line on the right hand side. So we'll start out at this X, and it moves upward as you add heat to the system, and eventually it will cross this intersection right here. And that is thermodynamic state for state 2. All I know is a specific volume, and I know that I've got saturated vapor. So we can look at this chart, and I know the specific volume of the vapor, and it's 0.1 cubic meters per kilogram. So I'm looking somewhere in this table. Can I find something as I come down? Temperature's coming up, the specific volume is going down, and the smallest one that I see on this table is 0.127 cubic meters per kilogram. And that occurs at a temperature of 200 degrees C. But when I look just qualitatively at this, it looks like I'm incrementing about 0.015 or something like that. And it looks like I'd move down a couple more rows. Just eyeballing it, I bet I've got a temperature of 210 degrees C. So with the table I've got, my best guess is I've got a temperature of 210 degrees C. So let's do this using ease. You'll see that we'll get a more accurate answer. Let's give this a variable, we'll call it T1. Use the temperature function and use water. I know I've got the same specific volume. I also know the quality, and that quality is equal to 1. So at this point, I've got enough information to define my system, and I can have it return a temperature for me. So if I check the units, I have established units of Celsius for that. So I'm ready to go. So I'm going to calculate it, and my guess at this point, based on what I've looked at from the table, is that I'll see a temperature. So let's take a look at that. I'll push the calculator button to run it. Indeed, something really close. We had a temperature of 212.2 degrees C. So this is the temperature that occurs when the last droplet of water evaporates from the system.